Sometimes marriages look alike. So when you look at these shoes on my feet, they look really similar. But there's actually something different about them. Mm-hmm. What is the difference?
One is a tie, one is a slip on.
Go ahead, my dear, ask me your hand.
One is a Stacy Adams.
Maybe now people see things differently. One's a tie, and one's a slip-on. And the reason why I'm doing that, I want to show the demonstration, because there's something different between these two shoes that relates to marriage. The slip-on is very easy to take off, where the tie is very difficult to take off. And the difference between the two is the laces. The laces is what allows the shoe to have a tighter grip on your foot. And this morning, the notes that I'm going to talk to you about are laces.
Amen.
And if you embrace these laces, it'll allow your marriage to have a tighter grip. Because when people don't have laces, they have slip-ons. And they easily slip out of the marriage. They easily slip out of the relationship. Because they don't have any laces holding it together. So I'm not trying to hurt you. I'm trying to help you. And when you're single looking for a man, you either wonder, do you have any laces? And so when we look at the first paragraph, it says when we were up here talking about marriage, we want to give you the tools to make your marriage tight. Someone say, make it tight. Many marriages look the same, but some are missing the laces. Laces are used to tighten or fasten together. My wife and I, and the Lord in particular, wants to tighten up your relationship with your spouse. I'm not saying your marriage is bad, but I'm saying anything can get better.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
When my wife was talking last week, I felt it needful for me to add some thoughts. So I want to address the issues that are prevalent in society in the second paragraph, because of circumstances and situations that is the role of the man in the marriage relationship. I want to address the role of the man in the marriage relationship. No one teaches us or teaches you how to be a parent or teaches you how to be a husband. And so with the advent of so many single parent homes, specifically women-led homes, men don't have the privilege of seeing a good marriage. The men in movies, music videos, reality TV, etc., don't portray a godly example of marriage. Amen. All we see is arguing and fighting as a norm. And so let's break down a few laces this morning that I pray will tighten up your marriage. Amen. Every marriage, like lace shoes, can use a little tightening up.
Amen.
Ephesians chapter 5, verse 21 is where we're going to springboard from. We're going to read through it and we're going to go back. Amen?
Amen.
You know, I was privileged. I'm from a different generation, as you might know. My mom and dad were married for 32 years until my dad died of cancer. Mm. He died at 62, the age that I am right now. So he didn't live out, as I feel, his whole life. But the only thing I remember clearly about my dad, he used to kiss my mom all the time, every day. He used to kiss the kids all the time, every day. He kissed us all our life. Even as we were growing up, we got older, Dad, kiss me. Because what was he doing? He was showing affection and love. And I believe that's what kept my mom and dad together. Did they have a perfect marriage? No, but there was love in the atmosphere.
Amen.
And I believe as a young man, I was raised to understand the power of love. But today, kids are raised to understand the power of arguing, manipulation, and anger. And so families are being raised, no one hugs anybody, no one kisses anybody. People come to this church on a regular basis and we hug them, and they don't know how to do it because they've never been hugged. And it's very prevalent in our whole society. But God's going to turn these things around. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
Ephesians chapter 5 verse 21 says, submitting yourselves one to another in the fear of God. Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husband as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, and he's the Savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be to their own husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it, that he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of the water by the word, that he might present it to himself a glorious church, not having a spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but it should be holy and without blemish. So ought men to love their wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife loveth himself, for no man ever yet hateth his own flesh, but nourishes and cherishes it, even as the Lord the church. For we are members of his body, of his flesh, and of his bones. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall be joined unto his wife, and they shall two be one flesh. This is a great mystery, but I speak concerning Christ and the church. Nevertheless, let every one of you in particular so love his wife, even as himself, and the wife see that she reverence her husband. Very powerful text. And we see the foundation of the text in verse 21. The foundation of the text is submitting yourselves one to another in the fear of God. Both parties, man and woman, being willing to submit to each other. Wow. See how I'm following the paragraph? Keep your hand down. Just listen. This morning I got a lot to say. Maybe I'll answer your question. We'll ask questions in a moment. Does that mean I'm not the head anymore? No, it means both of you respect the other person enough to serve them. Submission means to serve. And in a relationship, each party is serving the other person. There's a misnomer that says, you're to submit to me as my wife and you're to obey my commands. But submission by the wife has nothing to do with the husband making demands. The husband's responsibility is to love the wife. And if you love her right, you won't have to ever command her to do anything. She'll do stuff so willingly, you have to be like, that's all right, baby, you don't have to do it. Because of the power of love.
Amen.
What are you going to say about that?
What happened to the end of "to death do you part"?
Just, that's why I said, just listen to
me. Okay.
Yeah, there's a lot to be said. Yeah. Okay?
Okay.
"To death do us part," we'll probably wade into that somewhere midway.
I'm sorry.
Right. Because that's all right. Sometimes we have so many thoughts in our mind about things like marriage, and we probably should just have an open forum where people just ask a bunch of questions, because it's virtually impossible to cover every thought that a person might have, because it's such a vast subject matter that you try to narrow in on areas that God is showing you is important. And this morning, I believe this issue that I'm dealing with is really important, that we understand the real concept of marriage and the relationship between man and woman. And it's important that we understand we both submit to one another. You have to remember that when God created man, he says, I'm going to make him a helpmeet. I'm going to make him a woman to help him. And so what happens is sometimes we think that the woman is behind us or under our feet or some other position, but literally the woman is beside us. And then we have the woman and we don't need their help, because we don't understand that you do need the woman's help. Otherwise, God would have never made her. God says, I'm going to make you a help. You need, not a want, you need a helpmate. In relationship, in marriage, God recognizes the power of family. And in the family, one person cannot lead that family. It takes the two working together to achieve what God wants to accomplish. Mm. Anything that God builds up, the devil wants to tear down.
Right.
So you have to understand, in our nation, the enemy has slowly, nothing happens overnight, he has slowly destroyed the family. And he does it bit by bit, little by little. Even the women's lib movement, even though it's designed to give women freedom, the devil used it to try to usurp the power of the family. To say, I don't need a husband, I don't need a man. You can't tell me what to do. Listen, it's not about telling you what to do. It's about the roles that God has given us as men and women.
Amen.
So we have women say, I don't need a man, I'm strong as a man. And scientifically, a woman is not strong as a man. She's not made, her body is not made the way a man's body is made. It's because that's how God designed us. And so then you have the society trying to feminize men, trying to make them be emotional. And the Lord says, listen, that's not what I called men to do. I didn't call men to be emotional. If I want them to be emotional, I'll make them into a woman. Hello. So submitting is an act of service. You have to understand, nothing wrong with emotion. Emotion has its place. But it doesn't have its place in the life of a man. It has its place in the life of a woman. If all women were like men, all hard and unemotional, the child would suffer. Because when children are raised, they're raised by a man and a woman. A man has a role to impart into the child certain characteristics that the child doesn't have.
Right.
And he can't impart every characteristic because there are characteristics that the woman has. The sensitivity, the patience, the long-suffering, the love, the care. That's so important to make up a person's character.
Right. Mm-hmm.
That's why I'm a caring person because I had a mom. But that's why I'm a firm person because I had a dad.
Right, right.
We have men that aren't firm. All they have is a woman. They're all caring and weak and crying over everything. Get up and stop crying. Wow. The reason why we say that, because a man needs to be firm. Yeah. If he expects to lead a family, he can't afford to be emotional.
Right.
Come on now.
Would you? You both have something to bring to the table. We're in the paragraph. When God created Eve, he told Adam, I'm giving you a helpmeet. Helpmeet is not someone that's under your feet, but a person that's something you don't have. Helpmeet means just that. It's not deep revelation. It's someone to help. Something that needs to yield to the will of another person. See that? Submitting one to another. That means you have to yield to the other person's suggestions at times. One person don't have all the answers. Mm-hmm. Bad marriages, you see bad marriages when you see a husband never listen to his wife. Mm.